Hello and welcome to In Case You Were Considering, the podcast where somebody on the internet has a negative opinion on something and tells you all about it. I have seen thousands of movies in my day, and I like pretty much every last one of them. I like watching good movies, I like finding the little scuffs in the otherwise well-polished surface of those, I like watching mediocre movies, just turning off my mind for a bit and watching some people punch each other, or even a crappy rom-com that is so formulaic you can see all the plot points happening an hour and a half before you even start watching it. And I like watching crappy B-movies that are never really going to be critically acclaimed, but they have those specks of gold in them. Here's some special effects that are great. Here's a bit of writing that was really well done. Here's some acting from a no-name that actually works out quite well. Here's a well-set-up scene. I like finding that kind of thing in movies. But every now and then, there's going to be movies that are just unsalvageable. They are just such a mess from beginning to end. They're going for something that just doesn't work. And they're the few movies that I actually dislike. The ones that I would never, ever go back to, and the ones that I would warn people off against. And so the purpose of this podcast is pretty much to warn you off of these movies. This time, I'm actually going to be looking at two movies for the price of one. The Human Centipede 2 Full Sequence and The Human Centipede 3 Complete Sequence.
Martin, I'm here today because your mother is very worried about you.
He keeps on talking about a centipede with 12 people. What does that mean? What is this?
100% medically accurate.
One digestive system? Is this a perverted film you've been talking about?
I'm doing it! It's a film! You have sent me to film!
Now, for those of you who pay attention to some of our other shows, I actually enjoyed the first Human Centipede. I enjoyed it quite a bit. It was fairly subtle. It had something original in it where the villain sort of succeeded midway through instead of being stopped or stopped at the last minute, thus preventing his evil plan from coming to fruition. Instead, you're stuck there with the Human Centipede and sort of watching the victims sort of have to deal with that. It gets under your skin and it sort of squicks you in that sense. Now, Tom Six said when he started doing the second Human Centipede that he was going to make the first one look like My Little Pony in comparison. That pretty much tells you all you need to know. He's not trying to do anything intelligent, he's not trying to do anything clever, he's just trying to shock you. And it shows. What you've got in this one is, of course, bigger, better, more. More is always more, because if less is more, more must be more, right? So instead of a 3-person chain, now it's a 12-person chain. And he also starts with his seeming obsession with making the films within themselves. We start off with a guy who's sort of a creepy loner watching the movie over and over again. He loves the crap out of this movie, and he starts fantasizing about making his own. The story behind him is that he's abused by his mother, usually verbally. He was sexually abused by his dad, and his mom blames him for it. He's abused sexually by his psychiatrist, because why not? His neighbor's a jerk to him, and for whatever reason, this movie's pretty much all he has. It's his only friend. He loves it. He jerks off to it, and he has a little scrapbook all about it. And he starts considering, maybe I should make my own. And so, of course, he does. He starts kidnapping people and locking them in the basement of the parking garage where he's a security attendant. And this is where it starts just getting too much right off the huff. Instead of doing something like, I don't know, darts with some sort of random tranquilizer, using chloroform, even though that wouldn't technically work, it's, let's just crack them on the back of the head with a hammer. Because that's not going to kill them outright, obviously. Hammers don't do that. And he starts dragging person after person. He's trying to get a hold of the original stars from the movie, which he loves so much, in order to put them in his own Human Centipede. He ends up getting a hold of one and kidnapping her, and the other two luckily get away with not having to be in this movie. During all this, you see a bit of more of his home life. He's got this scrapbook that his mom finds and destroys, so he snaps, finally, kills her, and kidnaps his neighbor, who's a complete jerk to him as well. There was almost something interesting going on with him in his home life, and of course, because it's interesting, they had to completely squash that. It's not violent, it's not bloody, it's not gross enough, it's not going to shock you enough. So Tom Six is like, nope, can't have this. Other people find him masturbating with sandpaper. Hey, that's gross, let's throw that in there. Eventually he's got his 12 people, and he doesn't actually say anything in the entire movie. It's definitely implied that he's mentally handicapped. So what he does is he starts doing what anybody who doesn't know what the hell they're doing when it comes to surgery, and he starts messing up. Kills one person accidentally, then just grabs a stapler, starts stapling everybody. He's beating them on the head with the hammer so much it's not even making any sense at this point. Cutting the ligaments on their legs just randomly. Eventually he staples the 11 remaining ones to get, well, 10 remaining ones, because a pregnant woman seemingly dies. And now, well, he's got his little chain, forces them to walk around a little bit, decides, well, time to wrap my dick in barbed wire and have sex with it, because why not? Because it's got to be shocking, right? It's got to be more. It's got to make the first one look like My Little Pony. And of course, the first one had a scene where they shat into each other's mouths, so I guess we have to inject the person at the front with a laxative so that the shitting is that much grosser. Otherwise, it wouldn't make the first one look like a children's show. And that's pretty much all you've got. The pregnant woman comes back, she runs away, gives birth in the car, and the baby just splats out onto the ground underneath the pedal, which gets stuck when she's trying to escape until she crushes the baby's head. It's pointless. It's just, let's throw out these random things to try and titillate whatever juvenile fancies somebody might have. It ends up with basically him losing his mind, trying to kill everyone, getting a centipede enema. Then it turns out that it's all in his head. Because, sure. Is that a clever twist? Not really. It's a dumb end to a dumb movie. And the third one makes the second one look intelligent. I couldn't believe that they managed to make a movie that was so much worse than the second one.
Our prison has the highest violence rates, legal and medical costs, than any other institution in the U.S. correctional system. Things will have to change fast. I think I have a solution. No more prison fights. No more assaults on guards. No more disrespect. We've got to make a human centipede of our prisoners. They will literally be on their knees begging for your mercy. It's brilliant. Mr. Tom Six, creator of these films, claims that it's 100% medically accurate.
I don't speak with a stupid filmmaker about his poop fetish.
What do you think, Doc?
It looks medically accurate.
I don't see why someone couldn't survive a lifetime.
Peace on earth, goodwill to men.
This is a violation of human rights. It's certainly a violation of federal ethics. You insane freaks will get the death penalty.
This is beyond medieval torture, beyond castration, the ultimate correction. First human prison centipede.
This is exactly what America needs.
Once again, Tom Six says that he wanted to make the second one look like a Disney movie, so he's obviously going to up the ante just more and more and more. The one thing that I actually found entertaining and amusing with the third movie, right off the huff, is you have the actors from the first three movies. Now I say three because they actually got Brie Olsen, who did the porn parody as well. She's in it as the secretary. Then you've got the guy from the second one as the assistant, and you've got Dieter Laser as the warden of this prison, where the assistant, who's seen the Human Centipede movies, comes up with the bright idea of, hey, let's get the inmates all nice and calm by putting them in a human centipede, and he's just trying to get this idea going. He's doing his damnedest. In the meantime, the warden is just the biggest dick in the world, who's got blackmail on his secretary, who he's constantly molesting and raping and degrading, and then just doing whatever Tom Six thinks is gross. Orders a bunch of dried clitorises from Africa to eat for strength, torturing inmates just because he's a psycho. The governor wants violence to be down in the prison? Well, mass castrations, and then I'm going to eat some testicles, because sure. Everything is just done to some sort of stupid extreme for absolutely no real good reason. And if there's one thing that'll make you hate this movie, it's the way that the warden is talking the whole frickin' time. Every fucking word he says is protracted and fucking takes forever and fucking is fucking annoying as fucking fuck. If he spoke normally and didn't insist on saying fuck every third word, he would cut down this movie by about 10 minutes. I wish that was kidding. It ended up being so mind-numbingly boring, and if there's any sin a movie's gonna commit, it's that it is dull. You just don't care at all about anything. One of the other sins is if you're watching a movie and you can't get sucked into the internal logic. Like I was saying in the second one where he's knocking people out by cracking him with a hammer, all I can think is, no, you've killed these people 5 times over. How long has it been that you've been trying to kidnap these 12 people? You're calling someone who's in the States, you're in Britain ostensibly, so what, you have these people just beaten with a hammer over the head, locked in this basement for a week? No, like I'm not buying into the fantasy, this illusion you're trying to sell me. But the third one is just so boring. The only thing that's breaking it up is his constant torture of the inmates, who eventually get upset because he buys into this human centipede idea after the castration doesn't work, and he has a bad dream, which may or may not happen after the riot. I kind of forget exactly the timeline, but the riot makes him scared. He's worried that they're actually going to come for him. And during the riot, of course, his secretary gets left behind, beaten and raped into a coma. Of course, later on, when they go visit her in the hospital, he's like, well, might as well fuck her as well, in front of the assistant, who's got a huge crush on her. Let's just upset the audience, because I'm shocking. Ooh. Clever and original. Beyond this, they start going around from cell to cell, killing anyone who's not going to fit in the human centipede, killing the person who's a crazy coprophile and wants to be in the centipede. If you're in death row because he doesn't have to take you out again, well, cuts off the arms and legs and turns him into a human caterpillar. They bring in Tom Six as a consultant for this whole thing, because as I said, like in the second one, he starts doing this whole, it's this meta movie within a movie thing going on, which not really working for me. You can say whether or not it's clever or not on your own, but it's not anything that's going to make or break any of these films. They're going to suck either way. The governor comes in, hates the crap out of this idea. Dieter Laser's going around, the warden's going around just killing random people for no good reason, killing doctors, killing his assistant for wanting some of the credit because, you know, he came up with the idea, just killing everyone and claiming to be the most American person there is with the most German accent you've ever heard. 3 minutes later, the governor comes back and suddenly loves this idea. Tom Six is suddenly grossed out by this idea. Is it supposed to be satirizing the prison system? Presumably, but I don't know what the hell message he's going for, because the human centipede works. Is he saying we should go whole hog if we're going to do anything like that? Or is he saying that that's bad? Like, there's honestly nothing here as a social commentary. It's just an extreme showcase of something. I couldn't even tell you what. But of course, as I said, he's going to make the second one look like Disney. Is he talking about anything, or is he just making something that's supposed to shock people, that's supposed to upset them? Elfinlied, there's lots of torture and abuse in there, but at the end of the day, it's more so a series about how we all need just sort of a little bit of love, even if we have issues going on in our lives, and that's the one thing that would have made everything better, but everyone lives in a crap sack world there, so things don't work out for the better. And it's upsetting, but it actually offers sort of a glimmer of hope in that being upset. Or if you talk about Oliver Stone's Natural Born Killers, it was a very upsetting movie to a lot of people. He was doing it as a satire of how we're treating serial killers and glamorizing them. Serial killers actually have groupies. He's saying that this is possibly a bit of a problem because of the way that we're treating them, and he did that to an extreme and actually had a message behind it. Art should probably have some sort of message, otherwise it's just shock porn, basically. It's here, let's show you whatever gross stuff I can to upset you, and we'll all Twitter with glee like little juvenile idiots. I mean, are you trying to say something with your film? Are you trying to subvert standards in order to tell a familiar story, but in a different way? He's not really doing any of these things, and he admits it himself. He wants to just do something gross. Having seen these two movies, and not really having seen any of the other things that he's worked on, I wonder if the first one was just basically blind, stupid luck. I might take a look at the supposed psychological horror that he's doing next, to see if he's just really bad at making sequels, and if with something brand new, he might be able to actually do something a bit more subtle. If he wants to do some gross out stuff, fine, but have some sort of purpose, or at the very least, don't be boring about it. This movie felt so long, and as I said, just listening to the warden say anything, and most of it is him talking, just them talking, broken up by scenes of unnecessary torture. Just talking and torture, and every word he said made me hate him so much, and I enjoyed him in the first one. I know he can do a good job acting, but no, not in this one. If you really want to get more Human Centipede, watch the porn parody. It is so much better than either of these movies, and is actually pretty quality. I think it is fairly funny. Cut out all the porn, whatever. It's actually funny and worth a watch. These two movies are not. So in case you were considering watching The Human Centipede 2 or 3, just watch The Human Sexipede instead. At least that one's entertaining. It's amusing. They're trying to do something with it. Here, it's just shock porn. If you're really into that, there's even better shock porn out there. Find something else. Don't support this garbage. Maybe check out his other movies. I don't know. We'll have to see what the reviews are, if The Human Centipede was just a random spout of luck or not. So until next time, I've been your host, Dustin Friesenhan. Take care.